to those that actually support the aspiration to extend the railway lines. That's pretty much everyone. Okay, thank you very much. We've now got OMP, Bob Seeley, who's going to talk about sort of what he's been up to and going to be up to in terms of supporting what the aspirations of the island are.
Chris, I'm just thinking this is going to be working. Can people hear me okay? Is this working?
Yeah. Okay, thank you very much indeed. I have a dreadful lurgy still, so I shall try not to cough into the mic and deafen everybody. It's been my great privilege to be, it's an enormous honour and privilege to be your MP, and I have been so since June. I'm going to try to make myself as popular as possible this evening. So it is nearly 9 o'clock. I will limit myself to 2 concise minutes. Thank you so much to Michael, to David and Chris for organising, to you all for attending, thank you. And to Kilf, the Bus and Rail Users Group and the Isle of Wight Steam Railway, and what a wonderful presentation. And thank you so much for your foresight 30 years ago, that's wonderful. The new franchise gives us a unique opportunity. And the reason why we're discussing all the things that we're discussing tonight, that in 3 years' time, 4 years' time, or 7 years' time, we're not going to have the opportunity that we have now. And so the important thing for me is that if we're going to think big, we do so now to try to get as much investment into the railway as we possibly can. What I think we need to achieve, I'm just going to run through very briefly before I come to the extension argument, the general points. We need a new passing loop. I, as much as I'd love a 20-minute service, I think it's probably not feasible, although our British Rail engineer at the back made a series of very good points, including that one. But I think we need a 30-minute passing loop, so we have a 30-minute service that aligns with the ferries. We need significantly better ride quality. We need improved speed. It's never going to be a high-speed line, but I mean, it feels like a Land Rover on a bridleway at the moment. We need newer rolling stock. We need the development of Wright St John with the steam railway. There's a few people I talked to at the council who said, well, the steam railway is a bit of a side issue, frankly. I think actually the steam railway is critical to the success of Ireland Line and vice versa, because if Wright St John becomes a centre of visitor attraction, which helps with regeneration, let's say maybe with, if we have newer rolling stock, it won't need so much looking after. We can give the Isle of Wight Steam Railway the 1864 depot so they can put more of their beautiful, lovely old kit in there with the coach parks, and we get the coaches going to Wright St John, and we get people coming to visit the Isle of Wight Steam Railway and Wright St John, and get the numbers near 150,000 to 200,000. It's already over 100,000, phenomenal numbers. They employ 30 people, let's employ 30 more by making an even bigger success of the steam railway. And clearly, if you get an extension to Newport, if it ever happened, and it's a significant if, and we'll come to it at the moment, there will have to be a track rent agreement where we pay the Isle of Wight Steam Railway, Ireland Line pay the Isle of Wight Steam Railway to run over their track. So the Isle of Wight Steam Railway and their foresight in securing the track all the way to Wootton is integral to the future of public transport and rail on the island, which I think is very important. What else? Very briefly, significant improvements needed at Ride Pierhead and Ride Estonade. They are far too tired and they are critical gateways to the island. Cycle storage facilities, and I'd love a cycle route along part of the railway or as much of it as possible. Again, that depends on funding from Sustrans and elsewhere. I'm agnostic about the length of the franchise. It might be that track access agreement works best. I'm now going to come to the extension point. I had, in about 2 or 3 meetings with South West Rail, I persuaded them to put in a question about the extension, because if we didn't ask for it now, we'd never have the chance to do so in the future. Ride to Shanklin, well, Shanklin to Roxor and Ventnor, and ride to Newport, with 3 miles of extra track and then running possibly on the Haven Street line. The reason for that is obvious for anyone who uses the ferry road on a daily basis, or indeed for anyone who drives down the eastern side of the island. We need to try to get much more traffic off our roads, and that includes cycle and it includes rail where possible. I am aware of the potential difficulties in extending the rail both to Newport and both to Ventnor because of the tunnel. I used to run up and down that tunnel in the 1970s, so you know, I think it's a fairly good link, you know. And it's got the water lines going through it. But apart from that, I suspect it's probably structurally sound. I'm aware that we'd either have to have a new route around Wroxall, which I think would be difficult, or compulsory purchase, which would be unpopular in Wroxall, although connecting the line would be popular in Ventnor. I suspect I'm going to get lots of angry letters in about a week's time. I will, of course, deny I said it. Hoping you didn't win today. So, if the stakeholders all say, let's have an extension, or let's look into it, that is not the end of the matter. We then have to go and talk to the Department of Transport. I asked Chris Grady in the House of Commons about 2 weeks ago, it's on YouTube, what about the Isle of Wight extensions? He said, yes, come and talk to me about it. The process will be out in January. There will be instructions about how we can apply. There is a risk that because we are an island, the numbers of people it can positively affect will be limited by the size of the island, even if we double our numbers in summer for visitors. So I will have to make sure that the system does not negatively affect us, as it sometimes does with funding. So it's the way that these things are calculated. I have made Chris Grady aware of that only 2 days ago in the House of Commons, and he said, yes, write me a separate letter in January, and I'll make sure that we'll look at the way that the figures and the, what's the word I'm looking for? We'll look at the way the system is calculated so it does not negatively affect the island. Even then, it might be that the government will provide a small amount of money, or you know, a minority, 30 to 50%, and the island will have to find the rest. And times are really tough. But what we need is a feasibility study. We clearly have had feasibility studies in the past, and we've had feasibility studies for Newport in the past. So we can give those feasibility studies to the Department of Transport, and they can come up with an updated model and an updated costs. So at the very least, we're aware of what the potential benefits will be and the potential costs will be. And that means that we then can collectively decide, or your elected representatives in the council will decide, whether they think it is therefore worth pursuing. The important thing for me now was that we didn't not include this. So we got the option to pursue the rail extension. And I think for me, linking up Ryde and Newport and getting Newport, effectively a Newport Portsmouth service, I think is important for regeneration. And it is important for Newport Harbour, because I hope good things are going to be happening in Newport Harbour in the months and the years to come. We want a cultural quarter in there based around Key Arts. We'd like a higher education facility and maybe a campus there in evolving into that into the next few years. There will be a little bit of industry going in there, hopefully sort of high-tech firms of some kind, if we can start attracting digital businesses, because the island in the next 2 to 3 years is going to have ultra-super-fast broadband. We will have amongst the fastest broadband speeds in the world, because we will have fibre to home and fibre to business produced by White Fibre and backed by the government. So we potentially, for once in, well, certainly for the first time in the last decade or two, we've got things starting to go in our favour. So if we can get the railway line in there to connect with Ryde, we'll have our two largest towns connected, and we can drive the regeneration of Newport Harbour, which in turn can help drive the regeneration of the island. So that's why I wanted the extensions to be in this document, in the South West Rail consultation, and I wanted you to have the chance to give your opinions. And I'm so glad, thank you so much for so many of you for supporting the idea. We can now potentially go and talk to the Department of Transport about feasibility studies. It is a long way to making it happen, and it may never happen, but I think we needed to have that chance to get the possibility of it happening, but also to show our ambition for our railway, to get the maximum and the most ambitious investment package for the railway signed off by the Department of Transport to make it as attractive as possible to use, and to get people on the rail and off off roads. Thank you very much indeed. I think that Chris, you're now going to wrap up. Thank you.
And this is only meant to vacate the room. But the people at the front here will stay here for another 10 minutes. So if you've got questions you want to ask individually, please come up to the phone and ask it on a one-to-one basis. And on the table over on the side here,